This was the week Canada had a chance to make a long-awaited announcement telling the world how many more Syrian refugees it will take over the next few years. At a UN refugee conference in Geneva, Canada and other Western nations were urged to do more. And last Friday, the Immigration Minister's Parliamentary Secretary, Costa Menegassa, hinted to CBC News that Canada was coming close to an agreement with the High Commissioner for Refugees.
I can tell you that we've been working very closely with the Commissioner to try to identify the best way that we can improve upon what we are already doing, which is very good.
But CBC News has confirmed that Menegassa traveled to Geneva, held meetings, and returned to Ottawa without announcing any new commitment. Sources close to the discussion say Canada is seeking to resettle only refugees from Syria's religious minorities, something that's likely difficult for the UN to accept. Laura Lynch, CBC News, Toronto.
As many as 75,000 homes and businesses are without power this morning across southern BC. Damaging winds overnight have brought down power lines, with the majority of the outages being in central Vancouver. This comes after a week of near record rainfall in the region that has left many areas with ongoing flooding and mudslide concerns. The fallout from Canada's free trade agreement with the European Union has Newfoundland and Labrador Premier Paul Davis in Ottawa today for a meeting with Prime Minister Harper. CBC's Vicadopia reports.
Newfoundland and Labrador does support CETA because the seafood industry has a lot to gain. Europe has agreed to remove tariffs on Canadian seafood, but they want something back. They want the province to drop what it sees as a trade barrier. It's called minimum processing. You catch fish off Newfoundland, you have to process some of that fish in the province. It's a way of maintaining jobs, so Europe wants that gone.
Senator Harper
said it would soften the blow by kicking in 70% of the $400 million fisheries cost. The province announced this last year for R&D, marketing, infrastructure. Premier Paul Davis says Ottawa is suddenly changing the terms of how the money could be spent. So Premier Davis says that's not what they agreed to, and he's threatened to withdraw the province's support of CETA.
At the CBC's Vicadopia in St. John's. After almost 3 years of testimony, a $20 billion class action lawsuit against three Canadian tobacco companies has wrapped up in Montreal. Plaintiffs include 1 million Quebecers who claim the companies knew they were making a harmful product but hid the health effects. The defendants are Imperial Tobacco, JTI McDonald, and Rothmans, Benson & Hedges. New labor laws being proposed by the Italian government has led to a nationwide strike today that has the country at a standstill. In Rome, Megan Williams has details.
Most of those marching here in Rome and around the country are union members, but they're also young people who have been shut out of jobs. Italy has a 43% unemployment rate for young people, and those who do have jobs are usually underpaid and moving from contract to contract. Italy's been in a deepening recession for the past 5 or 6 years. Its new young center-left leader, Matteo Renzi, says the way to lift it out of joblessness and under productivity is to make it easier for companies to hire and fire people. But the people protesting today say making it easier to fire people won't solve the thing. That inefficient public administration and corruption are the real problems. Megan Williams, CBC News, Rome.
And that is CBC News to this hour. We broadcast live and podcast at our website, cbcnews.ca. And of course, you can hear us as well on Sirius XM Radio, we're at channel 169.